Grace, mercy, and peace be unto you from God our Father, and from our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. Today, as you may have noticed, is a Sunday of transition. While we are still in the season of Lent, we take a shift in focus today, and we focus quite a bit of attention on the last few days of Jesus' earthly life. Even the service itself is a transition. It began this morning with the joyous shouts and festal singing from our children, all the while waving palm branches, recalling the wonderful Bible imagery of our King, our Lord Jesus Christ, riding into Jerusalem. This we are reminded of again as the words of Zechariah, who prophesied the glorious entrance of this humble King of the Jews. And then our readings begin to turn. Why was this King, this man, this God, riding into Jerusalem the way he was? St. Paul reminds us in Philippians that he made himself nothing. The very God of heaven and earth was born in the likeness of men and became obedient to the point of death. This is the end of our transition this day. Our gospel lesson is the passion history of our Lord as told in the Gospel of Mark, recalling for us not only his trial and the struggles of that last day, but ultimately his death and his burial in the tomb owned by Joseph of Arimathea. Transitions. From this day to our own lives, transitions are unavoidable. Some are happy, some are sad. Some are easy, some are difficult. But all of them are what it means to be a human being. We all have times when we are happy and feel like waving palm branches and rejoicing and singing songs. We walk in public, we come to church, and we're just glowing. We just can't wait to tell someone this wonderful news that is happening in our lives. Grant your verse for this day. For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have eternal life. This is the good news of great joy. Onward the Christian soldiers march, because the victory is won and heard, read in the Gospel of Mark. Jesus has died for sin. He gave his life for yours. He died, and we have eternal life. Transitions. At times, the passion of Jesus is hard to read, as it reminds us of our own times of hardness and sadness and struggle. This can happen even in the church. We don't feel like going out much. We may come to church, but we really don't want anyone to ask us anything or talk to us much. We would rather hide and sneak out before someone guilts us in the Bible study. Then there are times of death and sickness and gossip and lies and yelling and long nights and anxious prayers and shreds of doubt. Destiny, your verse for this day. I can do all things through him who strengthens me. It does not matter where you are at on the transition scale at this moment, or tomorrow, or the next day. You are never alone. This day of transitions reminds us of this week of transitions. The flow of our lives that are lived out from birth to death, where we live, learn, love, and are loved. Coming at the end of this week of transitions are those very transitions of Christ that bring us comfort and peace to us right now, today. He strengthens us. As food and drink are needed for strength of the body, he feeds us with his body and his blood for the strengthening of our soul. This God gave his Son for our forgiveness, for our eternal life, for our strength, comfort, hope, and peace. He died and was buried for our sins and failures to love each other. He broke the gates of death by bursting forth out of the tomb 1 week from today, so that our final transition in this life is not really our last. Our bodies will pass away, but they will rise again on the resurrection of the dead. Then in body and soul there will be no more sadness, no more pain, no more struggles, no more death. That transition is already yours. Through your baptism, you have already died and been buried with Christ. You live every day in his grace, living as a child of God. Your brother cried, my God, why have you forsaken me? He did this so that you may only cry out, Abba, Father. Amen. May the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus our Lord.